Good morning to all the students of class 7. Students, you have got your maths project. You have got the topic. Today, I am going to discuss how you are going to do the project work. The topics given are making quadrilaterals, parallelogram and kite. And the next topic is finding area and perimeter of a rectangle. Children, let us discuss the procedure of starting the project. First of all, I would like to mention that you are going to do the project work in your maths homework notebook. In the first page, you are going to write your name, roll number, class, section, and subject. You make sure that you write them very clearly and neatly so that when you click the pictures for submission, the things which you write is visible. Alright. So in page 1, you are going to write your name, roll number, class, section, and subject. In page 1 means from where you begin the project. Next, in page 2, you are going to write the method and the topics. So in the first page, from where you begin the project, you are going to write the name. You are going to write your name, then roll number, then write class, then write section, then write the subject of the project which you are doing. Alright, this will be all about your first page. Now turn the page and go to the next page. In the next page, you are going to write formative assessment. Then you are going to write the method which is given, that is case study. Children, you can use colored pens or pencils except red and green. Then write the topic. After writing the method, you are going to write the topic. So the first topic you will write and the second topic you are going to write. The topics which are given, exactly that you are going to write. You can write it in the form of numbering also. You can give the bullets and also write it. Now, for the first part of the project, you are asked to make a parallelogram and a kite using a colored paper and paste it in the page. Children, you are going to use one page each for each type of quadrilateral. That means the two quadrilaterals which you will have to make are parallelogram and kite. So after writing the second page, that means the method and the topic, you are going to the third page and first you are going to make the parallelogram. As shown in the diagram below, as a reference, you can see that you can use any kind of colored paper like chart paper, marble paper, etc., and then make a parallelogram. And after that, you are going to write two properties of the quadrilateral parallelogram. Now go to the next page. You are going to make a kite. You can attach threads or strings at its lower end in order to give it a look similar to that of an original kite. Okay, as you can see in the picture. So for the first part of the project, what you will do, you will give the heading parallelogram. Then you are going to make the parallelogram and paste it over here. You are going to make the parallelogram, okay? You are going to make it by cutting it from any kind of colored paper. Then write any two properties. You are going to write any two properties. Property number one, you are going to write it, and number two, you are going to write it. So in third page, you are going to write, you are going to make the parallelogram, paste it, and write the two properties. Now go to the next page and you are going to write kite. Then after making the kite, using the colored papers, the strings and the threads, like if you make the kite in this way, you are going to paste it, okay? You are going to paste it over here. You can give a look similar to how an original kite looks. So you are going to use any kind you want. You can decorate it in any way you want, then write, then paste it, and after that write the properties. So you will write the two properties after pasting the kite which you will make. And make sure, children, that you write two properties of each of the two given quadrilaterals which you are going to make. So this is all about the first part of the project. Now let us come to the next part. In the next part, you will have to take an envelope and paste it there. As you can see, the reference picture has been shown. You are going to take an envelope and paste it there. Measure its length and breadth. You are going to measure the length and breadth of the envelope. You know that an envelope is the shape of a rectangle. You are going to measure the length and breadth. Calculate its area and perimeter using the appropriate formula. So children, you have done a lot of sums based on the area and perimeter of rectangles. So here, as you can see in the picture, that an envelope, picture of an envelope is shown. You are going to place a scale on top and measure its length. And again, you are going to place a scale over here and measure its breadth. So now, when length and breadth are known, you can take out the area and perimeter. You can calculate its area and perimeter. You can use any colored envelope also. And you can also make any kind of envelope at home and then paste it over there. Now you are going to go to the next page. After finding the area and perimeter, you are going to go to the next page. Now let me show you one thing, that you are going to paste the envelope over here, right? You are pasting the envelope over here. Then you will write its length, okay? You are going to write its length in centimeter. Be careful. And you are going to write its breadth also in centimeter. You are going to paste the envelope over here, then write its length, breadth. Then you are going to write area equals to, I hope you know the formula, then perimeter equals to dash centimeter. So you are writing the length equals to dash centimeter, breadth equals to dash centimeter, then area equals to, you are going to write the formula, then find out dash centimeter square, and perimeter also you are going to write the formula, then after that find out the measurement. That means you are going to find out the perimeter. You are going to write the formula over here, then after that you are going to write the formula, then after that find out the perimeter. Okay, first write the formula, then find out the values. So in this way you are going to find out the length and breadth and area and perimeter of the envelope. Make sure that you paste the envelope on top. Now you go to the next page. In the next page, what you will do is you are going to take two pieces of square papers. That means you can cut out two square pieces of paper from any colored paper, all right? But make sure that the two pieces which you cut out has to be from of two different colors. Suppose the first square which you cut out is of pink color, next has to be any other color apart from pink. It has to be, say, yellow. Suppose yellow. Now after that, what you will do is you are going to join the two pieces. You are going to join the two square pieces. You are going to join the two square pieces and then paste it. After cutting out, you are going to join the two pieces and then paste it on the page. Now here, see, you will have to write the name of the figure which is obtained. So the square piece which you are cutting, it has to be of size 3 cm. The square piece which you are cutting, it has to be of size 3 cm from two papers of different color. Okay, keep in mind that you cannot cut out from a single color paper. The two square pieces has to be from different color papers. So now you are going to join and paste the two pieces. Okay, don't paste it, don't leave any gap in between when you paste the two squares. As you can see in the diagram, suppose this is the square one and this is the square two. You will paste it. Then after that, you will have to name the geometrical figure obtained and then write the conclusion that what is the geometrical figure you have obtained, and you can write the, you can give a name to it. All right. So children, you are going to do the project work, entire project work, you are going to do it in your homework notebook. You will have to do the project work in your homework notebook. I hope all of you will enjoy doing your work, and do not forget to label the name of PDF by your name only at the time of submission of project. All right, children. So thank you, all of you.